Hi guys, welcome to another Angular 7 video tutorial for Absolute Beginner by TechTechTuts in 2019. In this complete Angular 7 crash course, we will learn the basics of Angular 7, and then the upcoming parts we will learn the each and every component or part of the Angular 7 packages. So the first question came into the mind that what is Angular? So Angular is an open source and front-end based web development platform which performs best when used for building dynamic single-page applications, and it is developed and maintained by Google. So basically, Angular is a front-end based web development platform, so you can only design user interfaces and user experience by using Angular. Furthermore, it is best to use when you are building dynamic websites and single-page applications. Later, we will see what are the dynamic websites and what are single-page applications. So if we compare the traditional web applications with single page applications, in traditional web applications, these are runs from the server's end. So every request client sent to the server, and then server renders that data and responds to the client, and then client will show that information inside in the browser. Here we take the example of client as a browser, so which in turn requests the server. The server simply holds over business logic data and render over website. So basically everything on the client or on the browser, you have to send a request to the server in a traditional web application way. So whenever user click on any of the link when this application is created using traditional web application, the client will send a request to the server, and then the server will handle this request and will send back a response which contain HTML code which browser will render, and final response is shown on the user. The main problem with this approach is that when I spend a lot of time sending the request to a server and getting the response, so it will increase the HTTP request response and request time, and which will slow down your applications. So in the traditional web application, if we look at single page application, here still user have to click and send the request, but when this request is fulfilled, then each and everything else other thing will be handled by the clients on its own. It renders the HTML page through JavaScript. So naturally it raises one more question, then where is the role of the server? So I mean, if everything is handled by the JavaScript, then what is the purpose of using the server? So in the single page applications, server will play its role when the user needs some data that must be processed by the server. Say for example, database operation, creating, reading, updating, deleting users from the database, or any information or some business logic that must be stored at server side. And of course, at the time of initial loading, in only these cases, we will send the request and wait for the response. If we talk in short, much of data will not traverse through the internet, which will make application to run faster. So if we compare traditional web application with single page application, we can see that every link is requested will be processed by the JavaScript, and only the business logic or database queries will be sent to the server, and then the server responds to that particular request. So in that case, we have to use APIs with single page applications. So now let's talk about some Angular version history. So Angular is in the market for almost 8 years. The version which you are using currently is not the first version launched right now. The latest version is Angular 7. Then which one was the first one? Let's quickly move to the version histories of Angular. So if we see Angular version history, the first version was called Angular JS, which was released in October 2010 on GitHub. And it was version 1, was launched in June 2012. It is referred to as Angular JS or Angular 1.x. It is based on JavaScript and it uses client-side model view controller. I mean, there is a server-side model view controller as well as there is a client-side model view controller, and Angular JS is the best example of model view controller from the client side. So everything is done from the client. Only when you need some business logic or some data from database, then you connect with the server. So after Angular JS, there was Angular 2, which was a complete rewritten of Angular 1.x. It was announced in September 2014. Angular 2 is a TypeScript based framework, and TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript. So in Angular 1, we don't have TypeScript, we have pure JavaScript, whereas in Angular 2, there was in TypeScript introduced, which is a superset of JavaScript. Microsoft planted and seeds, and Angular team adopted it for development purpose. It is based on service and component concepts. After Angular 2, there was Angular 4 version, and they have been skipping of version 3 to avoid confusion with the Angular router version 3. So because when there was Angular version 2, there was a very important module for Angular, which was a router, HTTP, or you can say Angular router. Its version was 3 at that time, which was working with 2. So rather than launching Angular 3, they have skipped the version 3, and there was no Angular 3, and they launched Angular 4 version. So Angular 4 is compatible with Angular 2 because the team did not want to break the ecosystem. So Angular 4 and Angular 2 were identical, and there was only bug fixes and few small changes has been done in Angular 4. So Angular 4.3 was a minor release, which means it does not contain any drastic changes. So when it comes to the Angular 5, Angular 5 was released in November 2017 to support progressive web apps and material design. So in Angular 5, we have support for both progressive web apps and material design as well. Angular 6 was a major release in May 2018, and it focused less on the framework but more on making it easier to move ahead with Angular in future. Major differences in Angular 1 and Angular version 2. So there was major differences in Angular 6 as compared to Angular 1, 2 or 4. The major difference between these two frameworks is that AngularJS is a popular JavaScript framework and Angular is a TypeScript framework. So because Angular 5 or 6 is also based on TypeScript, so that's why the major difference was that AngularJS was purely based on JavaScript, whereas Angular 2 from 2 version or 2 plus, if we say, so 2, 4, 5 and 6, so it was based on TypeScript frameworks. Also, AngularJS was not mobile oriented, but Angular was developed keeping mobile phase in mind, so it's modular approach and it is focused on mobile development as well. So Angular has more language choices than AngularJS. With AngularJS does not support single page applications, whereas Angular does incorporate this phenomenon and support single page applications. And the controller concept of AngularJS was replaced by component in Angular version 2. Then the latest version came, which is currently version 7. So Angular 7 is currently a major release, which launches in October 2018. Angular 7 includes following feature. It introduces some new features, like it have drag and drop feature, CLI prompt. When you create a new application, it prompts you some information and take input from you. It also supports virtual scrolling and improved accessibility of selects. And also it's introduced and improved Angular elements. Also the dependency updates like TypeScript was updated, RxJS was updated, and Node.js version 10 and later version is officially supported in Angular 7. But at the same time, it still supports version 8 as well. So we have talked about Angular and its history. So now let's see some of the advantages of Angular. So number one advantage is it is a component based, and because everything in the whole architecture of the Angular is based on components, so which allow reusability and modularity. So that is why it's also called modular framework as well, because we create components and those components can easily be used with another applications. Also, the Angular is a cross-platform application structure. I mean, Ionic, React Native, and Native scripts are such examples of mobile applications which support by Angular. So you can use Angular in Ionic, React Native, and Native scripts as well. So TypeScript writes JavaScript. In Angular, the TypeScript is used to write JavaScript. It means you have to create everything in TypeScript, then it compiles it into native JavaScript. So TypeScript plays a vital role in the place where you don't know JavaScript. You don't need to know JavaScript, but here I must say that you should understand basic concepts of JavaScript as well. So here you write a simple program in TypeScript and it automatically gets converted to JavaScript. So the TypeScript have extension TS, which is converted to the JS extension. Then we have a concept of services. So they are sets of code which can be shared by different components of an Angular applications. So if we have a data component which gets data from a database, this can be shared so that it could be used by other components when required, which brings consistency. So basically we have a service architecture which we normally use to communicate with different components and which also be able to fetch data from different services like RESTful APIs, etc. So let's talk about productivity. With greater consistency, you get the added benefit of productivity. When you learn how to write one component, you can write code in all other components with the same guideline keeping in mind. So if you have a one component, you can easily create other components as well. So TypeScript make debugging very easy. So TypeScript code can be debugged easily in the browser as long as proper file binding is done at the compile time. But still, we are not satisfied with this, right? Let us take a look to the real life feasibility. So let's get started with Angular. So the number one thing you need is an IDE, or you need a text editor. So there are many text editor choices available in the market, especially Sublime Text 3 and Visual Studio Code. I will recommend personally Visual Studio Code, although there is there are other JetBrain IDEs as well, but I will definitely recommend Visual Studio Code because it has various extensions availability. Moreover, TypeScript snippets are there, which will add frequently used code snippets, because Visual Studio is a product from Microsoft, as well as the TypeScript is designed by Microsoft. So you will have many useful components and frequently used snippet as well inside Visual Studio Code. So after choosing an IDE, the next step is Node and NPM. So without installing Node or NPM, you cannot install Angular on your system. So make sure that you have installed the latest version of Node on your machine by going to the nodejs.org/en and downloading according to your operating systems. So when you install Node, it comes with NPM as well. So installing Node will install Node and NPM at once. After performing installation or after performing this step, just check the version of Node and NPM to ensure proper installation by firing following commands. So if you type node-v and you get a proper response with a version, then it means that Node has been installed. Same goes with the NPM. If your command prompt answers the version of for NPM and Node, then you are good to go to the next step, which is the install Angular CLI. So Angular CLI command line utility is responsible for quick project generation and setting up required components and much more. Type following command at your command prompt to install Angular CLI. So to install Angular CLI, we have to run npm install -g at angular/cli, where g stands for the global installation, so that you can access it from anywhere. If you are on Windows system, then you simply run this command. If you are on Linux or Mac, you have to put sudo install, and then you need to write sudo npm install -g. Once your Angular CLI installation is completed, then you can use ng new command. Ng, where is ng, stands for Angular, and new stands for you are going to create a new application with Angular, and then you give it a name which will create a directory with the same name. And after this, go to your working directory and issue the following commands. By going into the directory, you need to run ng serve-o, which will compile your skeleton application and open it into the browser. So guys, in the next video tutorial, we will do some practical and create the application and then install the Angular. And after that, we will learn different components, services, and everything, whatever is in the Angular 7, we will learn about it. So till then, take care, goodbye, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and don't forget to press the bell icon. So guys, thank you very much, take care, and goodbye.